This video is part one in a series of videos on graphing Excel 2010. This part is on introduction to pie charts and bar graphs. For this part, I will be introducing pie charts and bar graphs using data on the tuition and fees of CU engineering freshmen in the school year 2011 to 2012. That data I have listed in a spreadsheet. As you can see, I have two sets of data, one for the in-state students and another for the out-of-state students. The only difference between these two data sets is the actual tuition values. As you can see, the tuition values are the only numerical difference. All of the fees are exactly the same. The reason I'm pointing this out to you will be made apparent as soon as we compare the pie charts for the in-state and out-of-state students. The pie chart for the in-state students is here. As you can see, a pie chart is separated into different slices, and each slice represents a specific comparison value. For example, the large blue slice here represents the tuition, which is listed in the legend. The tuition, as you can see on the chart, is $12,650. If I hover my mouse over the slice, it'll give information about the particular slice. For example, it says that the series is in-state students, the point or comparison value is tuition, and the value of this is $12,650. It also says that this makes up 45% of the total payment made for in-state students. This goes on for the rest of the slices. The dorm, when assuming a double dorm room with the 19 meal plan, is $11,278, which is 40% of what the in-state student will pay. If I move on to the non-resident students, you can see that the pie chart looks much different. In this case, the tuition, which is $31,300, is 67% of what the out-of-state student will pay. Because of this larger chunk, it makes it seem like the out-of-state student pays less for the rest of the fees, even though those values are exactly the same. The same value, which is $11,278, which is the fee payment for the dorm, only takes up 24% of what the out-of-state student will pay, rather than the 40% that the in-state student will pay. If you want to compare specific values rather than just percentages of the value, you want to use a bar graph. This bar graph, which has a normal scaling of the values on the y-axis, compares the specific tuition and fees for both the in-state, which is blue, and the out-of-state, which is red. As you can see, the dorm with the meals, the student gold insurance, and everything else are exactly the same, but the biggest difference comes with the tuition payment, where the out-of-state student pays more than double of what the in-state student pays. Because of the values are so small for the rest of these fees, it's nearly impossible to see what they are on this chart. If you change the scaling on the y-axis, however, you can get a better look at the rest of those fees. The scaling on this axis is now a log-base 2 scale, which means that each jump on the axis goes up double of the previous one. So 1 to 2, 4, 8, 16, all the way up to $32,000. On here, it looks like the difference between the tuition of the in-state and out-of-state students isn't very big, even though we know the out-of-state student pays more than double of the in-state. But this makes it easier to see these lower values, where you can continue to see that they are the exact same value for both the in-state and out-of-state students. Although both these charts have the ability to represent the same data, there are obvious differences between them. For example, the bar graph represents the data in a series of columns, while the pie chart shows it in slices. Aside from this obvious difference, there are some more subtle ones. For example, for the pie chart, you can only see one set of information at a time, either the in-state students or the out-of-state students. For the bar graphs, you have the ability to compare them side by side on the same chart. Another con of using both the pie chart and the bar graph is that you can only use it with individual comparison points. Tuition, dorm, insurance, fees, etc. Neither of these work when you're working with a continuous data set. So to recap on the pros and cons of each, for pie charts, the pros is it shows relationships between related data. For example, it shows the relationships between the tuition and the fees of the in-state and out-of-state students. It also creates a visual representation for percentages of a whole. For example, the whole amount that an in-state student pays, only 40% of that is their dorm payment. Well, for the out-of-state student, 67% of what they pay is just for tuition. Another pro is that it can be formatted to display values or even percentages. In my case, I chose to use values because that was more useful to my example. But if you're going to be displaying voting trends, it may be more useful to show percentages, to say that 50% of the voters chose one option over another. Cons of using pie charts is that it doesn't display the total value that the percentages represent. In our case, the total value that the in-state student paid was only about $28,000, while the total value the out-of-state students paid was $46,000. It can also be misleading on values when comparing between two charts. In the case of the in-state and out-of-state students, it made it seem like the out-of-state students paid less on the fees than the in-state students. Pie charts also cannot compare separate sets of information using the same comparison values on a single chart, which is why I needed to have a separate chart for the in-state students and the out-of-state students. Pie charts are only effective with individual comparison values rather than a continuous data set. Bar graphs, the pros of a bar graph, is it displays differences between the comparison points, similar to a pie chart. It also allows for comparison between related sets of information using the same comparison points, like how we are able to graph the in-state and out-of-state student tuition information on the same chart. It can be formatted to display actual values, though in my case, I did not do that since there was a large amount of data, then having the numbers attached would have just made it more confusing to look at. Bar graphs, you can also change the scaling of the axes to better view the data. Cons of bar graphs is that if there is a large size difference between values in comparison points, it may be difficult to see the smaller values, which is why I had a separate chart with a different scaling on the axes to better see the smaller values. Bar graphs are also not as visually pleasing as the pie chart. This may not seem as important to you now, but if you're making a formal presentation, you want to have a visually pleasing presentation to keep the viewer interested in what you're presenting. And bar graphs are also only effective with individual X values, rather than a continuous data set.